Hi there. Today on Typical Books, we have some new releases for September, October. Now, I know I'd said I had quite a few and I was probably going to do another video sooner than later. Here we are. A lot more new releases have rolled in, so there's probably going to be another video within a week or two, just so that I don't have a half-hour video that is just all new releases spanning more than a month. So these releases, some of them are out already, and some of them are about to be released. I'll also have a little bit of a haul, sort of like a weird unhaul. No, it's not an unhaul. I don't know. It's a virus haul. I had to return to my workplace to reclaim some personal belongings. I had an umbrella and a few blazers and shoes that I really do like, and I wanted them back, so we had an opportunity to return to the workplace to gather up some of our belongings. That, for me, included books, too. So you'll get like a variety haul here. It's not all horror. But before that, it is all horror. Horror Writers Association members' new releases for October and some September. So to start us out, we have something that is totally new to me. Eric Guignard has put together a book called Exploring Dark Fiction. This is number 5 in the series, A Primer to Han Song. And this is coming out from Dark Moon Books and will be out by the end of this month. And this is the work of Han Song, number 5 in a series of scholarly primers exploring modern masters of dark short fiction, with translations by Nathaniel Isaacson, PhD, commentary by Michael Arnzen, PhD, and beautifully illustrated by Michelle Prebbit. Discover the vast and fantastic writing of Han Song. I don't know if I'm pronouncing, if it's Han or Han. So yeah, something totally new to me and maybe new to you too. Let me know in the comments if this is something that you are familiar with, if this is a writer, or if this series is something that you've already explored. Next up, we have Sisters of the Moon by Alexandrea Weis, and this comes from Vesuvian Books, and it is out on the 22nd of this month. After being sold for taxes, a teenage Moor is sent to a mysterious medieval convent where sisters stand guard over ancient relics. She soon falls victim to their gruesome secret, discovering an unearthly power that will shape her into a legendary leader among warring werewolves in a new take on the genre inspired by a lesser-known mythology. Cool. I like the cover of this book, too. This next book, Unsafe Words, by Loren Rhoads, has another beautiful cover. The covers seem to be getting cooler every month. This comes out from Automatism Press and will be out by the 20th of this month. In the first full-length collection of her edgy award-winning short stories, Loren Rhoads punctures the boundaries between horror, dark fantasy, and science fiction in a maelstrom of sex, drugs, and rock and roll. This sounds like it's right up my alley. Ghosts, succubi, naiads, vampires, the wild hunt, and the worst predator in the woods stalk these pages alongside human monsters who follow their cravings past sanity or sense. Unsafe Words. Really cool title, too. Really cool everything. Okay, so Under Another Sun by DM Siciliano comes from Dark Diva Press and will be out the 1st of October. The same date as Local Haunt. Haha. Ray's sister died a year ago, but she's been haunting him ever since, warning of impending doom. He thought he was crazy until his niece, his brother-in-law, and Mother Nature confirmed his suspicions. Now it's a race against time to see if he can save his family. This sounds very dark, and I don't mean to giggle, but it's like Mother Nature, and Mother Nature confirms. Do you know her? Does she call you? I guess so. I mean, I've never met her. Okay, so this is another fun cover. Maybe not as dark and artistic and beautiful as the covers I normally say, hey, this is a beautiful cover. This is a fun cover. Bloody Britain by Anna Taborska. Shadow Publishing has put this out, and it will be out on the 1st of October. Land of Hope and Glory, not in this collection of 14 UK set novellas and short stories, illustrated by Reggie Oliver, and I am suspecting that is who has done the cover. The cover is fun. Super fun. Teddy Bear Picnic, kind of fun. Highway 181 by D.S. Ullery. This is an Amazon release, and it comes again the 1st of October. A Cursed Highway brings death and destruction to the lives it touches in the second collection from D.S. Ullery, author of Beyond Where the Sky Ends. I used to have recurring nightmares about the ends of highways and highways crumbling into nothing and driving along and having barricades stopping me and then looking and the highway has turned into a sheer cliff face, not unlike Silent Hill. And for some reason, this is the idea I'm getting here. Now this cover is fun too, although of a darker nature. Stories We Tell After Midnight, Volume 2, by Rachel Brune, or Brune, I'm not sure how to pronounce that, from Crone Girls Press. This also comes out October 1st. We're sensing a trend here. This is just the bulk of these Halloween time releases that happen around Halloween for horror authors. You can notice this is like the ramping up. This is our time to shine. From the dusty streets of a small Mexican town to an overgrown old house in the Florida swamps, this collection of short horror fiction leads the reader into the shadows of a world just beyond the light of modern science and the comfort of disbelief. Okay, and guess when this book comes out, kids? Terra Nova, by various authors, with a cool throwback cover. I really like this. This comes from Engen Books, which is a publisher I've never heard of before. And this comes out on the 1st of October. Four unsuspecting Newfoundlanders have set out on the Terra Nova bus from St. John's to hear spooky tales and visit strange locales. They have no idea who their mysterious guide Simon is, nor the horrors that await them along the rocky inlets and winding roads. Newfoundland horror, I am there. I don't read enough from the coast. I mean, Anne of Green Gables is a tried and kind of wrung out trope of the East Coast. I would really like to hear some horror based from that end of the earth. That end of Canada, more specifically. And that is it for now. You'll notice, like I pointed out, so many of them come out October 1st. That means that we're going to have a whole new clutch. There's probably 10 in waiting already that I'm ready to talk about and that are slated for release after October 1st. But there's so many just concentrating right now. I didn't want to put out one big long video, and I'd rather give them up as we go, right? You'll see them all posted at horror.org on the new releases page, or you can go there and click on members books in the menu and check them all out. Now, as noted, the haul from work. These are books that I bought at work. We have a few lending libraries at my work, and we have a really cool permanent book sale where all the proceeds go to a good cause, and it's typically $2 a book or $3 for $5 or something like that. And they're all books that people had owned, and you bring them in and you donate them for free. Like, you donate them to this cause and they sell them to get their charity money, which is, I think, a very cool idea, a new twist on the lending library. I use that as a lending library. I'll often bring books in and, you know, pay the $2 and get another book and then bring it back and then pay $2 more to get another book. It works good for me. But you'll see that this is a mix, not all horror. First up, we have the Duquesne Diet. I don't know how to pronounce that. This was just some sort of oddball interest of mine, being interested in the carnivore diet and other sports nutrition. This was something that caught my eye, so I picked it up. This is The Way My Garden Grows by Barbara Dodge Boland. It has no dust jacket, so it's just a very plain little book. But it's just an interesting girl's anecdotal journey through gardening, from not having a green thumb at all to having a prosperous few acres that feeds her family. It's a very slim little cool book, and it's a fun read for lunchtime. Robert J. Sternberg's How Practical and Creative Intelligence Determines Success in Life, Successful Intelligence. So yeah, just another weird interest thing of mine. Life hacks, older book. It's not a fresh book by any means, but hey, worth $2. Something interesting to flip through. Not something that I've read cover to cover, but I've flipped through it. And some of the ideas in here are finding new homes on lifestylists' blogs. So interesting stuff. You've seen this one before. This is one of the French Goosebumps books that I picked up. This is Votre passeport pour un horrible cauchemar. This is numéro 7 from Le Cimetière Flottant, the floating cemetery, or I guess ghost ship is more accurate of a translation of that. But hey, I'm slowly but surely learning French. Kids' books, Goosebumps style is the way to go. James Patterson, See How They Run. Okay, I took the James Patterson Masterclass well before there were a million other Masterclasses. He was one of the early adopters of that particular style of helping people learn how to write. And he, if you're going to take a Masterclass, I highly recommend that one, mostly because I haven't taken any of the other ones. But I really liked listening to him talk. I've only read one or two other James Patterson novels back in the past. I don't even remember the name of them. But I saw this on the shelf and thought, why not? I haven't had a chance to read it yet. It's not typically the horror I go for, but, you know, it's got to start somewhere with James Patterson. I've heard other writers say, oh my God, I watched the Masterclass. I suddenly have a crush on James Patterson. What is up with that? Weird. Charles L. Grant's Shadows 2, a really cool collection edited by the award-winning anthologist Charles L. Grant. And there are other in this series, and this is a really beat up book. It's all taped together. I think I might have shown this off before here, but hey, it's finally back in my clutches from work after being there since March. This is one that I had posted on Instagram. I was so pleased to find this in such good condition for $2, Scottish Ghosts, Ghouls, Ghosts, and Beasties. And it's got some little illustrations in it, like little woodcuts. So I'm very pleased to have this in the collection. And I had picked this up right before lockdown, so it was basically lost there until I could return. Because there was under no circumstances could we return. We couldn't have people retrieve things, although there have been managers in and out of the building for various reasons, or those that work on sensitive information that are in and out of the building. It's just not for personal belongings whatsoever. Certainly not my precious copy of Scottish Ghosts. So yeah, I am so glad to have my stuff back. It was an eerie feeling returning to the office, I will admit. I had seen some photos of the office and how abandoned it looked. I had a lot more stuff there than I thought. If you look at my desk, it's very minimalist. There was a photo of my husband and me, and when I'm there at work, there's typically a little black Philip Funko Pop that sits on my desk, and this big stack of books. I had a whole bunch of stuff in my drawers. Oh my gosh. So it was a big mess to bring home. I was there a very short time. We were given 2 hours to collect our things. I took at most a half hour and happened to bump into somebody that I really think is cool at my work, and I got to chit-chatting, which was so nice and rare during this time. I haven't bumped into anyone I know out and about. And even so, to bump into somebody at my work that I typically talk about horror and movies with was very cool. It was a nice break. Although, it was kind of eerie being on my work floor with nobody else there. Very strange. But I'm just glad to have my books back, hey? So thank you very much for watching. If any of those new books are on your TBR, I would love to hear about it. And of course, if you've had any weird hallbacks, I don't know what to call them. Hallback sounds good. If you had a weird like moment where you have realized you've abandoned a book somewhere during this weird time where a lot of us are removed from our homes, if you live across borders, or from our workplaces, if you're suddenly working from home forever or without a job, if you have been removed from a library, a cafe, a small bookstore, a lending shelf, definitely let me know in the comments below, or maybe make this the next video that you do. Thank you again to all the new subscribers. There's been a lot of you, and I am so pleased to see new faces in the comments and in the rolling thing I get when someone subscribes. That's super cool. Thank you again. Thank you to Cameron Chaney for the shout out recently. That was neat. There's a few more coming up as it is that spooky, haunting All Hallows Read season. So I look forward to even more people joining the fray. If there's anything you think I should be reading, just let me know. And above all, have an ooky, spooky day.